Welcome, Clean Easy. The next few minutes could seriously affect your business. It's all about taking action now and fulfilling your potential.
Hi guys, my name's Craig White. It's an absolute pleasure to be speaking with you today. I've been asked to share some fundamentals with you and some philosophies to help enable you to maybe look to mirror some of the success that we've managed to create over the last 11 years with Clean Easy. And I want to share a little bit with you. In 2001, I returned from traveling with a couple of choices. And my choices were quite simple, to go back into the employed world or to actually get up and running with my Clean Easy business and have the freedom to be my own boss. And I'm going to talk to you about that a little bit later. Over the previous 11 years, by following a few fundamentals and working hard, we have created, you know, some phenomenal success, some consistent success. In fact, for the last 10, 11 years, we have consistently grown in turnover, income, and growth in people. Do you know, this is a people business built on relationships, friendship, and opportunity. You know, over the time, our income has grown from, you know, £700 to touching £8,000 every 4 weeks. And this period, I believe we'll be touching that magical £10,000. And that's exciting from a home-based business with no rents, rates, or overheads. Some of the other incentives the company offer have become part of my life. You know, for the last 10 years, we've actually qualified for 15 all expenses paid holidays of a lifetime. Let me tell you something about them holidays. The cost, the value of them trips in the last 10 years is probably worth more than I would have been paid had I'd worked in the corporate world. That's magical. You know, and them trips started off with my first trip back in Rome to my next trip being in New York. And there's one coming, which is Miami. But you know, one of the things is you can guarantee yourself a free holiday every year moving forwards from today. And that's one of the things I love about this business. You're rewarded for hard work. So that's been great, you know, to travel the world for free. Along with that, we've benefited from one of the other car incentive schemes, and actually back in 2006, won £35,000 worth of cars. You know, a Mini Cooper and a BMW at the time. I took one car, you know, I drove it for 6 months, got bored and part exchanged it on my dream car, which is a Porsche 911, which I'm still driving today, incidentally. And that's the power, these incentives, these car incentive programs, they're not company cars, they're yours to keep and do with as you please. And that's absolutely awesome. You know, where in the world can you work for yourself, work with an opportunity, and be rewarded with free holidays, free cars, and a phenomenal residual income? Because you know, that £8,000 a month, it's a great income, but it's the type of income it is, guys. Understand that, it's the type of income it is, and we can talk about that a little bit later. As well as that, we've managed with our team to be awarded, you know, considerable amount of trophies. In a couple of years running, we won a trio of trophies in the group. We've won the Distributor of the Year trophy twice. Last year, actually, our group won 5 of the 6 trophies. I believe that's a record, and we're looking to duplicate that in the future. But we've also been recognized as the Direct Seller of the Year Award, which is a DSA national award in the industry, which is a £10 billion industry. And that's exciting to know you're being recognized for being the top of your game. But the key is, when you're on top, you've got to work harder, and it's about having consistent growth. And I love this business with an absolute passion. I love the friendship, I love the challenge, I love the reward, and I love the money. It's absolutely wicked. So what I want to do over the coming few minutes, I just want to share with you some of my thoughts, my philosophies, and fundamentals that can help you make the shift and start to design your best ever year. But we'll talk about that soon. Hey guys, you know, one of the biggest challenges we face is making that shift from being employed to being self-employed. I believe it's one of the biggest challenges and one of the biggest obstacles and struggles people have with respecting themselves enough to employ themselves. You know, very much the extra miles between the ears. And I think people often talk about, you know, the old cliche, I suppose, of people love going to the gym, but it's getting to the gym that's the hardest thing. But once there, people really enjoy that time and feel good when they've left the gym. And I think our business is very much the same. It's having that discipline and that commitment to yourself and to your goals to be able to respect yourself enough to employ yourself. And it's really important that you maybe get a few things in place. And I think motivation is really important. Having that inner motivation to drive you forward, get you out of bed on purpose, with purpose, each and every day. And to be honest with you, I've never really struggled with that because, you know, I joined this business and I had goals, and I'm going to talk about goals in a moment, but I had certain goals, certain things that I needed to achieve and certain things that I wanted to achieve. So I was motivated. I saw an opportunity to work harder for myself than I ever had for a boss. And I was empowered by that. I was excited by that. But it's that challenge that we face to get up in the morning and respect ourselves, as I've already said, enough to employ ourselves. That's the challenge. So you need to have that motivation. You need to have that plan. And you need maybe some kind of way to hold yourself, somebody maybe to hold yourself to so that you can really drive forwards and move your business forwards. But one of the things I would suggest you do is understand this. Commit to yourself. Commit to your future and commit to those that are dependent on you, because you have an opportunity here. You have an opportunity to escape from the rat race. You have an opportunity to avoid drowning in a sea of mediocrity and become all you've ever wanted to be and create maybe a legacy for your loved ones. But it's about having that shift. It's about respecting yourself enough to employ yourself. And one of my biggest tips would be get the CD, Making the Shift by Darren Hardy. Enjoy it, listen to it consistently and adopt them philosophies, adopt them attitudes. And remember, your success will be about the choices you make and the actions you take. You know, I'm speaking about goals and I want to talk about designing your best year ever, and I just want to spend a bit of time with you on that and try and share some philosophies and some thoughts with you. Guys, these thoughts I'm going to share with you have helped me over the last 10, 11 years to live the dreams I had. Now, there's a little point for you. The dreams I had. And I want to talk about them right now. I want to talk about goals. I want to talk about designing your best ever year. You know, some people struggle with goal setting. Well, let me flip that for you and let me share something with you and a thought of mine. Every action we take with a goal in mind. Every action in life, every single action starts with a goal. Fact. So actually, you set goals and targets each and every day. What I want to challenge you to do is spend more time designing your best ever year, designing your life so that you can have all that you want to have and become all that you want to become. But you know, goal setting is quite simple. Goal setting is simply about getting passionate about your future. It's about having something to look forward to. Most people actually spend more time planning their family holiday than they do planning their life. Fact. Why do people do that? Because we like to have something to look forward to. It's important to us. It's important to have something on the horizon, something to work towards, something to, as I said, look forward to. Well, do you know what, guys? You've got a whole life ahead of you to look forward to. If you take a few fundamentals and a few actions, you can start to create your own destiny. You can start to design your own life. It's about having certain goals. You know, when I joined this wicked business, I had three simple goals. In fact, I had one goal, actually, and it was simply to earn £2,000 a month. I needed that. I'd moved back in with my parents, loved them to bits, but living with them was a flipping nightmare. But to earn £2,000 a month actually would have enabled me to be able to get that independence. That independence, I think we all crave a little bit. But actually, as that goal became apparent and it became real, I started to realize that along the way through achieving that goal, I could also achieve two other goals. And at the time, they was to qualify for a couple of the company's travel incentives, one being Rome and one being Malaysia. So I actually set three goals back in April 2001, April, May time. And that was to earn £2,000 a month, to qualify for Rome and to qualify for Malaysia. Three goals in 8 months. And then I sat down with the people around me, my mentors, my sponsors, my coaches, and we devised a plan. We devised the points of action that would enable me, should I take them, should I be persistent and consistent, I would achieve them goals. And that's the thing in life. You know, if you can set some goals, if you can design your own life, there is reference points of success. There is people around you that can help you plan your actions. Guys, I want to make a suggestion to you. I want to challenge you to read this fantastic book. It's called Design Your Best Year Ever by Darren Hardy. Do you know what? It's been a fantastic influence on my life since I've picked up the book at the beginning of this year. And you know, personal development has very much become a major influence on my life, and it still is today, and it will be in the future. This book will actually enable you to set and help you set some big goals and start to dream again, but importantly, set a plan in place to go out there and make them happen and make them a reality. Because I believe that's what life is all about. It's about having some dreams, and it's about taking the appropriate actions and becoming all you want to become. And I'm confident if you read this book, if you take the actions that it suggests, and if you follow through, you will succeed. So guys, you've got it all in your hands. You've got the support infrastructure around you. You've got the company that's guiding you and inspiring you and creating a vehicle for you to achieve all you've ever wanted. But you've got to decide what it is you want, and you've got to set the plans in place and take the action. It's all about the follow through, but get passionate about your life, and I challenge you to be all you want to be. Thanks for listening.